Yo, all my Black Panthers at, say all part to the people. Cheer. Yo, I just want to know when Black people gonna get justice. Remember Emmett Till? He got killed because a white person lied on him. I feel like every Black person who lives on the West Coast is a descendant of a refugee because we didn't immigrate here into America. We was kidnapped, and the ones who was over here was forced into slavery. But then after that, we still was persecuted. We went through all of these things in the South. Y'all seen the pictures of the Civil Rights Movement, and Black people fled to the West Coast. But then it's like, one thing that I learned from my mentor, Melvin Dixon, and the Black Panthers is never fall victim to the euphemisms coming from the state and the powers that be, the media. They use words like super predators, the war on drugs, Southern strategy, tax cuts, 13th Amendment, all of these catchphrases and laws, even to this day, laws like mandatory sentencing, stand your ground. I'm just saying all these things disproportionately affect Black people, and people act like they don't know that it does, and they act ignorant to the fact that it does, and they act like it's just Black people out here committing all these crimes because they put it on the news. And Black people need to stop believing this stuff. Just like they're talking about Trump in the Central Park Five in New York. But you know what I'm saying? They don't know that Central Park belong to people of color first. You know what I'm saying? And that the original crime was how they stole that park. You know what I'm saying? And back to the Central Park Five, it was Black people who led the way to convicting those boys by believing that and by just going along with what the media says, just going along with it. Know what I'm saying? Black people need to be more vigilant and more strong and stick together when it comes to defending each other. I don't know why we so quick to back down. The only time you stand up is when they put police violence on television. But then that's only for a minute, and then we go right back to doing the same things that we did, like 1982, Ronald Reagan, Nancy Reagan, and the war on drugs. You can get the rest of your life in prison for having crack cocaine, but powder cocaine is a slap on the wrist. Why is that? Simple, because they put crack in the ghetto and they put cocaine in the suburbs. And it's clear as day, clearly, that they want to lock Black people up. So they just finding a reason they want to lock. Not even just Black people, they want to lock people of color up, even poor white people who use drugs, while all the rich kids in the suburbs can use all the drugs that they want to. And they want to put them in rehabs, but they want to put us in jail, in prison, and destroy our families. And it's written in the 13th Amendment that once you go back to prison, you become a slave. That's in the United States Constitution. So I don't know what people are talking about. Slavery ended 100 years ago. In actuality, slavery never ended in the United States, and it's still existing to this day. In the prison industrial complex is a slave plantation. That's another euphemism, is in prison. That's a euphemism for a slave plantation. You know what I'm saying? And all of these laws and everything that are supposed to be justice, like how they are trying to change the ways, the ID so that people can't vote. Those things don't